Hi, I'm Damon Smith, Extension Field Crops Pathologist at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today we're out in a soybean field at the Hancock Agricultural Research Station located in Hancock, Wisconsin. And these are a series of white mold trials that we're looking at here. And so I want to just spend a little bit of time talking about white mold and the white mold life cycle and specifically how soybeans are affected by the fungus. The fungus that causes white mold is called Sclerotinia sclerotiorum. It survives in the field as small survival structures, which we call sclerotia. They're hardened, round, or irregular round black structures. And those structures are very important because what happens is in the late spring and early summer, as the rows begin to close and that canopy begins to fill in soybeans, a small mushroom-like structure called an apothecium forms. That apothecium then has microscopic spores, which are borne on the surface of the cup, on the top of that cup, and those spores are then forcibly ejected up into the canopy of the soybeans. And those spores will land on flowers or senescing flower parts in soybeans. So the window of opportunity for infection of soybeans by the white mold fungus is in the R1 to early R4 grow stages. That's also the prime time if you're going to do an in-season pesticide application, such as a Cobra application, Endura, or Approach, one of these fungicide programs. That's the window of opportunity to apply those fungicides. Once the fungus infects through the flowers, it then grows down into the stem and causes a damage on the stem. And the scientific name of this disease is actually Sclerotinia stem rot, and you can see it gets its name because of the rotting that we have on the stems. You can also see that the fungus has ruptured through the stem, and we have the white cottony growth, which is where we get the name white mold from. If we split these stems open, we'll also see internal damage inside the stem, and eventually more sclerotia will form on and inside this stem material. And you can see there's actually sclerotia inside already forming. At the end of the season, when we come through with our combines to actually harvest this material, our combines then spread those sclerotia back out onto the field. So it's very important at the harvest time that you either save fields that are heavily affected by white mold, you save those fields to the end of the harvest, or you're diligent about cleaning your combines between fields because those sclerotia can get caught in the combine and be spread out onto fields that may not have a history of white mold. In terms of management of this fungus, we like to see cultural practices and fungicide or pesticide programs layered on top of those cultural practices. This is a multi-pronged approach in terms of managing white mold in soybean. We know that using wider row spacings, going from a 15-inch row spacing to a, say, a 30-inch row spacing, which you're looking at here, can help reduce the amount of white mold in the field, and also dropping planting populations.
Here's some work with planting population where we actually imitated low and high fertility situations and planted at 160,000 seeds per acre or 100,000 seeds per acre, and further layered fungicides or the herbicide Cobra and compared that against the non-treated control. You can see if we look at the low fertility situation here, we get a nice reduction where we have 100,000 seeds per acre, and then a further reduction where we get Endura put on at the R3 growth stage, which seemed to be optimum timing in this particular situation. If we look at yield, we can see actually higher yields where we have 100,000 seeds per acre planted compared to the 160,000 seeds per acre, and we apply Endura at R3. Thus, we're recommending that folks consider dropping seeding rates in these environments where they have high white mold pressure.
Spend some time also studying variety trials and variety ratings. While we don't have varieties that are immune to white mold, we do have varieties with decent resistance out there, so you can also layer that on top. And then looking at those fungicide applications, and again, your window is somewhere between that R1 to R3 in terms of putting a fungicide on. And in order to help you make that decision, we do have an app for that. It's called Sporecaster. We've done a lot of research with that app, and that app was partially funded by the Wisconsin Soybean Marketing Board. What we're doing with that app is we're using the weather information during that bloom time in soybeans. We're pulling that down from the cloud, pulling it into the phone, And we're using some statistical models to actually make a risk prediction at that bloom time of whether you'll actually have white mold later in the season. And that tool can then be used to make that decision on whether you should be spraying or not, and when you might be spraying within that window of opportunity for the fungus. Again, somewhere between that R1 and R3 growth stage. The app is free, so feel free to go out to the Apple Store or Google Play Store and download that app to your phone. And it uses the GPS on your phone to actually find the weather information for that particular field. If you'd like to learn more about white mold or management of white mold or other field crop diseases, feel free to visit badgercropdoc.com or see your local extension agent.